Hello, my lovely crafters. This is Crafty Sue 519. Welcome to my channel. And today is my Saturday Mishmash. Well, I got a few little things for you today. I actually got in here yesterday and made cards. Yay! Every time I do that now, I just remember how much I miss making them. It's one of my favorite things to do. Grumpy and I got a card in the mail this week and got a couple little things at Dollar Tree. Nothing big deal. One little thing from Amazon. I'll show you, but like I said, nothing big deal. So let's see the card first. And this card is from my sweet friend, Bertha Wilson. Look how cute that is. The little dog. And it says, sorry for your loss. And it's about losing Tiki. And I forgot my glasses in the other room, so hopefully I can read. It says, Sue, I'm so sorry you lost your special little Tiki. I know you will miss her. And then there's a word I can't read. Something, you and Grumpy. You are in my prayers, Bertha Blessed Wilson. And that's sweet. So Bertha, this is going up where we have this little shelf in our family room on one side. It's our entertainment center where our TV is and all that stuff. And on one side is my tank, who was my pug. His ashes are there, and so are my niece's. And I got a few little pug things there in his picture and stuff. So Grumpy has done the same thing on his side, and he's got Tiki's ashes there, and I believe it was Denise who sent a card, and the vets did, and you. So these are all going to go up with Tiki. And thank you very much. It means very, very much to us that someone thought of us through this very difficult time, losing our little fur baby. It means a lot to us, Bertha. So we've had company this week. My nephew's mom is here visiting from Rhode Island, and we usually get together a day or two while she's here. We usually go to the casino, but we haven't done that. But she spent the day with us on Wednesday. She wanted to come do Starbucks Wednesday with us, so we did that. We went to Starbucks, and then we went to Dollar Tree, like we normally do. And I picked up a couple little things, nothing much. I saw more of these butterfly cards, which I love and I use a lot of, so I picked up two more packs of these. And then Grumpy saw this calendar, Magnificent Mountains. And if you don't know, mountains are my favorite places to be. I love to be up in the mountains. Always wanted to live in the mountains, never have. And so he said, you need this calendar for 2024. And all the beautiful pictures of all the different mountains. Love it. I do love it. So this will be my 2024 calendar, which I can already add things to. Of course, doctor appointments that I've already got scheduled for January and February and of next year. And then I was trying to do something the other day and I didn't have a small hole punch. I had a half inch hole punch, but that was too small. So I ordered a new one on Amazon, and this is a 3/4 inch punch, and it's EK Tools. The only punches I want to buy now are either EK Tools or Stamping Up. They're the best ones I've ever used. So add this to my collection. Still have to get more hole punches. I don't have a whole lot of them. A whole lot of hole punches. Oh gosh, I'm silly today. So That's my little hauls. Little hauls. Waiting for my paper pumpkin to come in. I was hoping it would be in for me to show it to you today, but it has not come yet. So I'll show you the cards I made. These will be the October birthday cards, and I will have these all addressed and ready to go while I'm away in Rhode Island, and I'll put dates on them so Grumpy will know when to put them in the mail. So they're similar but different, a la sheetload of cards. I went through all of my different sheetload of card instructions. I have tons of them put in a folder and found one that I liked that I thought would be appropriate. And of course I made them all in a fall style because it is October and fall is my favorite season. So I'll show you. So here's the first one. It's got the trees in the background and the leaves. I love this orange polka dot on here. And I just embossed this piece of paper with the happy birthday. I actually stamped the happy birthday first and then embossed the paper, which don't be afraid to do that because it does not ruin your sentiment, as you can see. And I do that quite a bit, quite a bit. I love my embossing folders. And then this is one of the stickers that I got from Dollar Tree. I thought that was so pretty. And then I just put a couple little jimmies on it. And there you go. And I think it's very pretty. And on the inside, it says, sending you smiles for every moment of your special day. And I put a little piece of that tree paper and a cute little pumpkin on the bottom. So that's number one. Number two is the same. They're the same cards, except I switched out the paper. This one has the trees in the background. This one has the leaves in the background and has the trees here. So just opposite, but it still has the orange polka dots in the same spot. And this one, all of them are pretty much the same. The only things that are different are the papers are swapped and the stickers are different. And this is a little gnome. This was a new set of fall stickers that I had found at Dollar Tree. And I put a little gnome one on this one. And the inside is the same, except we have the leaf paper, same sentiment, and a little pumpkin. And the third one is back to the trees in the background and the leaves up front, same orange polka dot. It says pumpkin patch. I love these stickers. They are so pretty. And of course, the happy birthday, the inside's the same. It's got the tree and the pumpkin, same sentiment. I really enjoyed making these. If you've ever followed Alicia, who does the sheetload of cards, they're awesome if you need to make a bunch of cards. Because they're all the same design. Each pattern is the same design, but you just swap out the papers, how you put them. And it's so easy to make cards. I recommend that to everybody all the time. Look up Sheetload of Cards. What is her name? Crafty Al. Call Me Crafty Al is the name of her channel. And she has some awesome ones from mini slim lines to big slim lines. The other day she actually did a 5x7. Most are A2s, but you just do it how you want. She just shows you how to put the card together and how to cut them out, and they're awesome. Some awesome. So this one's got the basket and the flowers, and reminds me of when I lived in Rhode Island. I lived out in the country, and I would put hay bales outside with corn stalks and Indian corn and pumpkins, and it was so pretty to decorate like that. And I would always buy a bunch of mums and put the mums in different colors around it. And I had a little porch on the front of my house, and it just looked so pretty and so fallish. I miss doing that. So I'm kind of sentimental towards this one because it reminds me of doing that same on the inside as the others. And the last one, same thing with the little pumpkins. I just love them. I love them. I love the fall. I love the colors. It's just my thing. So that's it. Sweet, short, easy. And I think they made very pretty cards. Let me know what you think. I always like to know what you think, because sometimes I get ideas and change things up a little bit, and it helps. It helps. I can take any kind of criticism. You hate them? Tell me you hate them. It's not going to make a difference, but if that's how you feel, say so. Anyhow, I hope you all have a wonderful, fantastic weekend. I'm off to crochet. I have not made a thing since my Wednesday, plushy Wednesday. Nothing. Well, I had company for 2 days. And yesterday, I don't know, I was feeling a little off. I wasn't exactly myself yesterday. You have those off days every now and again. Yesterday was mine. And so I really need to get started, because before I know it, my first market will be here. So have a great weekend. Remember to be creative, have fun, and do something just a little bit naughty. All right, everyone, until next time, love yous. Bye.